friends, welcome to Kamath Astrology. And in this video, we are going to cover one more important transit, that is Mercury or Budh, the planet which represents our intellect, is transiting into the sign of Cancer from Gemini on 25th July and is going to stay there till 8th August 2021. So let us analyze the impact of transit of Mercury into the sign of Cancer. Now, when Mercury moves into the sign of Cancer, it comes in conjunction with the Sun, and this transit also marks the beginning of the holy month of Shravan for the Hindus. Now, as you can see in this figure, Mercury is shown conjunct to the Sun within the purple circle, and from here Mercury aspects Saturn and Moon in the sign of Capricorn, and Saturn and Moon also aspect Mercury and the Sun. So the Sun represents our consciousness, whereas Mercury represents our intellect. The Sun is the universal soul. Cancer is the sign that controls emotions, that controls water bodies, and therefore Mercury as well as the Sun in the sign of Cancer indicates that our intellect as well as our soul are now influenced by emotions. That is, we make decisions based on our emotions. So let us analyze the impact of this transit for every ascendant. So let us begin with the Aries ascendant or the Mesh ascendant. For the Aries ascendant or Mesh Lagna, this transit is occurring in the fourth house of Cancer, and Mercury rules your third house of communication and your sixth house of diseases, debts, loans, legal conflicts. And he has entered into the fourth house and is conjunct the Sun. So what does this mean for you? So on the negative side, this can give you conflicts over property with your siblings, because Mercury is ruling your third house and he is also ruling your sixth house and is entering into the fourth house. So emotional outbursts related to property matters or with respect to the health of the mother can occur in this time period. Sun also represents the ego, and when in conjunction with Mercury and aspected by Saturn and Moon, this ego can impact your emotions and result in an outburst. On the positive side, with respect to your work related affairs, this is a good time. Mercury here gives you good intelligence to make wise decisions and move on the right path. In your workplace, in your business, in your profession, you are bound to see gains, because you have Jupiter in the 11th house, you have Saturn in the 10th house. There may be some mental stress because the Moon is right now conjunct Saturn, but Moon changes the sign every 2.25 days, and therefore this will be a short-term stress. So for the Aries ascendant, the summary is, it is good for you with respect to your professional front, that is your business or your career, but be aware of having unnecessary disputes related to property and health of your mother with your siblings. Now for a Taurus ascendant, Mercury rules the second house of Gemini and the fifth house of Virgo. Okay, and he is entering into the third house represented by the sign of Cancer. So this is a very good time for you. Luck will favor you. Your finances will grow in this time period. You will have a lot of courage to make bold decisions, to take new initiatives in this time period. Luck supports you in a big way. Just take care that you are not overwhelmed by the ego caused by the Sun. Okay, because everything is going well. So when ego takes over, a chance of fall is there. So just be aware of this thing. Otherwise, this transit is fantastic for you. Now, let us move to the Gemini ascendant or the Mithun Lagna. So for the Mithun Lagna, Mercury is the Lagna Lord, that is the first house Lord and the fourth house Lord. Okay. The fourth house deals with comforts, vehicles, mother, peace, happiness, sleep. Okay. And Mercury is entering into your second house of wealth and finances. So if you are trying to buy a new vehicle, if you want to invest in a new home, this is definitely the time for you to do that, to plan for that. Now, you may experience some delays in achieving the final result because Saturn is aspecting this combination. But nevertheless, Mercury and Sun give you financial gains in this time period. So, if you want to invest in a house, if you want to buy a new vehicle, it is a good time to do so. If you want to invest in stock market trading, again Mercury here supports you in a big way. In this time, your speech will also be very sweet. Okay, your seniors will like the way you speak. And this time will give you great gains. The only challenge is, since Saturn aspects the Sun, okay, and Saturn is present in your ninth house, so this may create some kind of conflicts with your seniors, with your superiors, if you do not control your ego. Okay, so just be aware of this factor. Otherwise, this is a very good transit for you because Mercury gives you the right kind of intellect and the ability to take right decisions in this time period. Now I'll move to the Leo ascendant or the Sima Lagna. Okay, so in the Sima Lagna, you can already see there are two planets, Venus and Mars, present. And as I said earlier, this increases lustful thinking. This is the reason also why you are seeing certain scams related to pornography now coming out in the film industry, because the sign of Leo is all about leadership. It is about the film industry. It is about creativity. It is about people occupying leadership positions. Now, what is happening is, Mercury rules your 11th house of gains and your second house of finances. Okay, and he is entering into the 12th house of losses and expenses. So what does this mean? This means in this time period, definitely there is going to be a great increase in your financial expenses. And this is confirmed because Saturn also aspects Mercury and Sun here. So definitely you are going to face some challenges on the financial front in this time period. The Sun, who is your Lagnesh, who is the first house Lord, has entered into the 12th house. Okay, so this indicates two things. Either you will spend your money on health related expenses, or you may spend your money by traveling abroad. And there will also be an instinctive drive within you to spend the money unnecessarily on things you don't need. So try to avoid that impulsiveness. And this is an average transit for you. I will not say that this is a very good transit for the Leo ascendant or the Sima Lagna. You can worship Lord Vishnu in this time period to control your financial expenses. Okay, because Lord Vishnu is the controlling deity of Mercury. And definitely Vishnu worship will give you a lot of peace. Now let us move to the Kanya Lagna or the Virgo ascendant. Okay, for the Virgo ascendant, Mercury rules the first house and the 10th house of profession or career. And now he is transiting into your 11th house of gains. Okay, but the thing is, he is sitting conjunct with the 12th Lord, that is the Sun. Okay, which means that you may either gain a lot of money through your foreign connections or in a foreign land, or the reverse can also happen. That is, you may spend a lot of money over your friends who are based out in a foreign land. So, on the financial front, this transit gives you a lot of expenses. Okay? But on the career front, this transit does good to you because Mercury is your 10th lord eventually. Okay? And he is entering into your house of gains. He is also aspected by the moon right now. Okay? Who is your 11th lord? He is aspected by Saturn, who is your 5th lord of luck. So, luck will favor you in this time period, in your workplace. But it will give you financial expenses. So, this is an average transit for the Virgo ascendant. Let us move to the Libra ascendant or the Tula Lagna. So, for Libra ascendant or Tula Lagna, Mercury rules the 12th house of expenses and the 9th house of good fortune. And he is entering into your 10th house of career, business and profession. And he is conjunct the Sun, who is your 12th lord. So, what does this indicate? This indicates that you will have to travel somewhere. Okay? During this time period. Because both the 9th house and the 12th house, they represent some kind of travel to a distant place or to a foreign land. So, in this time period, you will be forced to travel somewhere. Okay? And that travel will give you great benefits. You will gain from that travel. Your financial situation will be very good. Maybe you have to travel due to your work related activities. Okay? Because Mercury rules your 9th house and your 12th house and he is entering into your 10th house, which indicates that some work related travel will be there and which will prove beneficial to you in this time period. So, if you get a travel opportunity, go ahead with that. Now, let us move to the Scorpio ascendant or the Vrishicka ascendant. So, for the Vrishicka ascendant or the Scorpio ascendant, Mercury rules the 8th house of inheritance, occult activities, hidden things, buried things, secrets, and he also rules your 11th house of gains. Okay, and where is he entering? He is entering into your 9th house of good fortune. So, you will find that you will gain from activities related to inheritance, related to insurance. So, in this time period, you may get some kind of gains through inheritance. If you are involved in activities such as insurance, etc., you will also get good gains in those activities. And if you worship Lord Vishnu in this time period, it will bring you great good luck in the month ahead. So, for the Scorpio ascendant, this is a good transit. However, the health of your father may suffer in this time period because the 8th lord is entering into the 9th house, conjunct Sun, who also represents the father, and this Sun is being aspected by Saturn. So, definitely, you have to take care of your father's health in this time period. Otherwise, this transit gives you gain through inheritance, it gives you gains through insurance, it also gives you gains through occult activities. So, if you are engaged in occult activities like Reiki, healing, astrology, palmistry, etc., you will gain in this time period. Now, let me move to the Sagittarius ascendant or the Dhanu Lagna. So, for the Sagittarius ascendant or Dhanu Lagna, Mercury rules your 7th house of marriage, partnerships and your 10th house of career and business. And he is entering into the 8th house and is becoming conjunct with the Sun, okay, who is your 9th lord. So, is this a good transit? On the work front, in your partnerships, there can be emotional outbursts in this time period. Okay, your ego may be at an all-time high. And if you do not control your ego, if you do not control your speech in this time period, there will be conflicts with your spouse and with your bosses at your workplace. So, this is one thing you need to be very careful about. So, for Sagittarius ascendant Dhanu Lagna, this is not a very good transit. This is further complicated by the fact that Saturn again aspects this combination. So be careful with respect to your speech, because Mercury is all about communication. Sun is about ego. Okay. So when you are talking to your seniors, when you are talking to your spouse, maintain your calm. Okay. Do not get angry unnecessarily, because if you get angry and you say something, it will become a mountain out of a molehill. So Sagittarius ascendant, be careful, not a good transit for you. Now for a Capricorn ascendant or the Makar Lagna, okay, Mercury rules the 6th house of loans, debts, diseases, service, daily routine, and the 9th house of good fortune and luck, okay, and he is entering into your 7th house of partnerships. He is also getting conjunct with the 8th lord, that is the Sun, okay. So what kind of a transit is this for you? Now, because Mercury is your 6th lord and he is entering into your 7th house and conjuncting with the 8th lord, that is the Sun, okay, it is good for financial gains. It will give you a lot of money in this time period. But again, remember, Sun is the 8th lord, Mercury is the 6th lord, okay, and therefore some kind of disputes may come in your partnerships, in your married life in this time period. But Mercury also rules the 9th house of good fortune. So even if such disputes come, you will be able to easily overcome these disputes. So this is a mixed time for you. This transit gives a mixed result. And one more thing is, because Mercury rules both the 9th and the 6th house and is entering into the 7th house and conjuncting the 8th lord, if you are in a business partnership or managing a family-led business or having some kind of partnership with your father, then in this time period, there will be some kind of stress and dispute. Okay, so because Sun is the 8th lord and Sun represents light and is entering into the 7th house, so if there are any hidden affairs in your married life, if there are any extramarital affairs, those things will come out. So that is one thing you need to be careful about. Second thing is, if you are in a family-led business, if you are partnering with your father in something, then there will be some stress or dispute. On the financial front, however, this transit gives you gains. This is because Jupiter sits in your 2nd house. Okay, so if you see, for a Capricorn ascendant, the 2nd house is Aquarius, where Jupiter is transiting right now. And so he brings about an expansion in your wealth. For an Aquarius ascendant, you can see Mercury rules the 5th house of Gemini and the 8th house of Virgo. And where is he entering? He is entering into the 6th house of Cancer and conjuncting with the Sun, who is the 7th lord. So with respect to the health of your children, be a bit careful in this time period. Why? Because Sun is the Karka for health. Mercury is your 5th lord entering into the 6th house. Okay, 5th house also represents children. So be careful with respect to the health of your children. Do not get into speculative trading, speculative activities, because you are now being aspected by Saturn, okay, who is also your 12th lord. So if you engage in speculative trading, you will get losses in this time period. The health of your children you need to take care of in this time period. Since the 8th lord is entering into the 6th house, okay, it gives a Viprit Rajyog. That is, you will benefit from the losses of your enemies in this time period. So that is a good thing about this transit for the Aquarius ascendant. Now, for the Pisces ascendant or the Meen Lagna, Mercury rules your 4th house and your 7th house. Okay, and he is entering into your 5th house. So, this is a good transit for you. On your home front, there will be lot of happiness. In your married life also, there will be lot of happiness in this time period. Now, for the Pisces ascendant, let us also look at the Sun's position. Okay, the Sun rules your 6th house. He has entered into the 5th house. The 6th house has two hot planets, Venus and Mars. Okay? So, some disputes may come up with respect to females, with respect to elderly ladies in this time period. That is one thing you need to be careful about. But overall, this transit gives you a lot of happiness at your home and in your married life. Now, this is a very short transit. It is a transit just for 17 days, and Mercury is almost always very close to the sun. So Mercury is used to the heat of the sun. Okay, but the reason why this transit is important right now is because Mercury is entering into Cancer and Moon is not a friend of Mercury. Okay, and Mercury is conjuncting the sun and being aspected by Saturn right now. Another significance is this transit now marks the start of the Shravan month. So friends, this is my analysis of Mercury's transit into the sign of Cancer from 25th July till 8th August 2021. If you like this video, do mark it as liked on YouTube. If you are not subscribed to our channel Kamath Astrology, you can do so by clicking the subscribe button. For any consultation or queries, email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com and we'll be glad to assist you. To know more about us, visit our website astroseva.tripod.com. So friends, thanks a lot. We'll see you soon again with another video. Till then, bye, take care and stay safe.